So to kill off the grasses, I've used big areas of sheet mulching to kill off grasses, because I don't use chemicals in terms of, you know, herbicides and so on. I use various types of sheet mulch, and I'll show you a bit. In fact, I'll show you further on. There's several examples I can show you in one place, so I'll talk about that more there. So as we walk through this this section here, you'll see probably several plants you recognise. Some you might have in your own gardens, and you may not realise some of them are edible. So one is Aquilegia, columbine. Lots of garden varieties of Aquilegia. The leaves and flowers are very good in salads. Pretty tender, and you know, all through the season they stay quite tender. So that's a good one. In front of them here is one of the mallows just starting to flower. This is wood mallow, Malva sylvestris. All the mallows have good edible leaves. These ones, some of these are looking a bit manky. Obviously I wouldn't eat them if they're looking a bit manky, but wood mallow is one of my favourites, actually, for the leaf quality in salads. Very good. Of course you can use the flowers as well. That's a native perennial, as are many of the other mallows you'll see in the garden. The big leaf plant I'm standing next to is Japanese butterbur, which has edible leaf stalks. That's a perennial vegetable in Japan, quite well known in Japan. And as we go further on, you'll see a little bit further back, there's an area of Solomon's seal, which I'm sure some of you will know. And again, you know, Solomon's seal is a lovely early spring perennial vegetable. You eat the young shoots when they're about, you know, a foot high or something. In spring, you can cut the whole first flush of young shoots and treat them like asparagus. So just steam them lightly, you know, they only need a few minutes, and they taste like sweet asparagus, basically the flavour. And then obviously after that you need to let them come up again, reshoot and to regain their life. But they like, you know, Solomon's seal loves shady positions, as does Aquilegia, you know. So there's lots of perennial vegetables like these, you know, that will grow in shade. Whereas most of the annual vegetables that people grow will not grow in shade, because they're all from sunny places, you know, like the onion family, most of which is from sunny, of course not wild garlic, which is down there. You know, the cabbage family, which is from the seashore, and things like the squash family and courgettes and sweet corn and potatoes. These are all full sun annual, mostly annual crops, some of them perennial. And if you try and grow them in shade, they won't crop at all. Okay, so you can't put annual vegetables in a place like this and expect to get a crop. It won't happen. You can have annual vegetables within a forest garden, and I do, but you have to have an open sunny spot or sunnier spot, you know, for them to go in. You can't have them under trees. But there are, as I say, plenty of perennial vegetables you can grow under trees, just that most people don't know about them. Because we're not very good at using perennial vegetables in this country. You know, artichokes and rhubarb, I suppose, are probably two that most people know and use. But apart from that, there's very few others. And it's partly the way that, you know, that agriculture and horticulture has developed, you know, over the past hundreds of years, that there's been an emphasis on annuals, whereas, you know, perennials have been forgotten pretty much. And there's, you know, a lot of fantastic edible perennials.
Excuse me, is this burdock here or not?
No, that is a type of rhubarb.
All right.
And I'll show you another one a little bit further up.